Failing a drug test used to be the quickest way for an athlete to be kicked out of the Olympics. Now, it's their opinions. A Greek female triple jumper got booted from her team before she even made it to London because of a racist tweet about Africans. And a Swiss soccer player got sent home after he tweeted insensitive remarks about South Korea.
So I think at this point it'd be silly to be surprised that athletes like the rest of us occasionally don't know when to hit the save button as opposed to when to put something out live.
When sitting up here, the cameras and microphones are a good reminder to not say anything stupid. But smartphones are deeply personal devices, and there's something safe and private about typing a message until you hit send.
In the Olympics, I'm learning that very quickly, that when you say something in a locker room, chances are that what is said in a locker room will stay in a locker room. But when you say something on Twitter, then that is going to be seen and going to echo all over the world.
Some of the athletes are using social media to push the International Olympic Committee to change Rule 40, which prevents athletes from promoting sponsors during the games.
Those rules have been around much longer than social media. Social media has only been around for 6 or 7 years. Clearly, issues are raised more quickly, but they're still the same issues that we have to deal with.
American soccer player Hope Solo used Twitter to criticize NBC commentator and former soccer player Brandi Chastain. Solo said, "It's too bad we can't have commentators that better represent the team and know more about the game." Whether it's used to entertain or inform, social media is a beast that is almost uncontrollable and very popular. Mark Carlson, Associated Press, London.